Hey, hi, hello, Comic Book Nation, it's BD here, and I've got your second printing of the biggest news of the week, ranging from the Venom sequel suddenly being exciting, to a Titan Season 2 trailer fulfilling every DCEU fan's dreams, except the Snyder Cut. Let's start with comics. Marvel published House of X number 2 this week, the third in Jonathan Hickman's 12-issue run between House of X and Powers of 10, leading to the relaunch of X Comics later this year. And this book was a doozy. Spoiler warning, as it turns out, Morva McTaggart has had mutant powers all along. I told you, spoilers. And that power is the power of reincarnation. This is essentially Groundhog Day stuff, or for the younger viewers, Edge of Tomorrow stuff. I hope you've seen at least one or both of those movies. Every time she dies, she goes back to the day she was born and experiences a new timeline starting at that point. After living through 9 lives with bad outcomes, Moira is using her 10th life to get Professor X on board with a newer, brighter future, and our mind was every bit as blown as his was in this moment by this whole book. We won't spend this whole video diving into the theories, there are a lot of them, but I suggest checking out comicbook.com/Marvel and hitting up folks like Matthew Aguilar and Jamie Lovett to talk more about this. Speaking of Marvel, we finally have a reason to care about Venom 2. Listen, if you liked the Venom movie, I'm not here to shame you for it, that's fine. But it just wasn't a good movie, no matter how good Tom Hardy is as Eddie Brock. But now Andy Serkis is coming in to direct the sequel. Andy Serkis, Gollum from Lord of the Rings, Caesar from Planet of the Apes, the genius behind so much of the motion capture technology and other innovative filmmaking happening right now, is heading up Venom 2. And what this really probably means is that he will fix that awful Carnage wig. Oh, we don't have another Medusa on our hands. Interesting note, the comic Andy was holding in his post about this news is one which sees Venom and Spider-Man team up, so is this an MCU crossover, or is it the R-rated Carnage Venom movie we all want? We don't really know yet, but time will tell, and it's all very exciting. But if you want R-rated right now, look no further than Titan Season 2. The first season of this DC Universe show featured plenty of foul language and violence, and now Season 2 is going everywhere the DCEU couldn't, complete with Easter eggs to match big screen moments like the reveal of Ben Affleck's Batsuit, or that time Zack Snyder showed us Deathstroke for the first time that never ended up happening. These moments will actually be carried out, and characters like Wonder Girl, Bruce Wayne, Ravager, Jericho, Aqualad, and more all have been revealed. So keep up the cries for the Snyder Cut. We hear you, so we can only imagine WB has to at this point. But also, I suggest enjoying Titan Season 2 in the meantime on HBO Max. What did you think of the trailer? On a sad note, Netflix canceled yet another show. The OA is dead after 2 seasons. A lot of people are mad about it, which isn't a great look considering Disney Plus is going to be bundled with Hulu and ESPN Plus starting later this year for just $12.99. The Walking Dead introduced a new character in the form of Brandon. No, not me. But he is very important based on the comics. We got this image of him with Negan, which is fitting considering he is the character who tried to break Negan out of jail and get him over to join the Whisperers, only to get killed by Negan and set up the redemption arc, which we're already seeing on the show. Meanwhile, drama alert, Tyrese and Michelle Rodriguez are throwing shade at Hobbs and Shaw, which had the lowest box office opening of a Fast and Furious movie since Tokyo Drift. We know Tyrese has had his beef with The Rock and he loves the attention for putting it online, so his long-winded Instagram comment about this movie not having a monstrous opening weekend, not really a surprise. I'm just personally wondering, what else has Tyrese been doing that he feels he can even talk this way about any movie? By the way, Hobbs and Shaw hasn't opened in China yet, so maybe factor that into those box office numbers. Those are the biggest stories of the week. This has been the second printing. I'm gonna go back to sitting alone and wishing Nova was announced for Phase 4 of the MCU. For more, stay tuned to comicbook.com. I'm Brandon Davis. I'll see you there.